वंदे गुरुपद्वंदम भक्तबिंद समन्वितम श्री चैतन्य प्रभु वंदे नितानंद सहोदितम श्री नंद नंदन वंदे राधिका चरणोदयम् गोपीजन समयुक्त बिंदावन मनु वाशाकुवश कृपा सिंधु पतितानं पावन वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः मूकं करोति वाचालं पंगुं लंघयतगिरिं यत्कृपातमहं वंदे परमानंदमाधव वृंदावई तुलसीदेव वै पिया वै केशवस्य स्नभक्तिपदे देवी सत्वत्वई नमो नमः नारायण नमस्कृत नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयो मुदीरे संकीर्तने कृष्ण कथोपदेशे गौरीयपत्रस्य प्रकाशने च सदानुरक्त गुरुभक्तियुक्त भक्ति प्रमदाक्ष जगोद्वरुणु धैयं सदा परिभवग्नमभीष्टदोहं तीर्थास्पदं शिव विरंचनुतं शरण्यं वीतात्तिहं पुनतपालभवद्विपूतं वंदे महापुरुषते चरणारविंदं यत्पादपल्लवनखचन्दमणिच्छटाया विस्फुरजित किमपि गोपवधू स्वदर्शि पूर्णानुरागरससागर सारमूर्ति साराधिकामयी कदा कृपां करोषि श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवसदि गौरभक्तबिंद श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवसदि गौरभक्तबिंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे आजानुलंबित भुजौ कनकावदातु संकेतनैकवितरो कमलायताक्षो विश्वाम्बरो द्विजवरो जुगधर्मपालो वंदे जगत्प्रियकरो करुणाभुतारो हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे नमामि गंगे तव पादुपंकजं सुरासुरैर्वन्दितो दिव्यरूपं भुक्तिं च मुक्तिं च ददासिनित्यं भावानुरूपेण सदा नरानां गंगातरंगरमणीयजटाकलापं गौरी निरंतर विभूषितवान् भागं नारायणो प्रियमनंगमदापहारं वाराणसीपुरपति भजवीशनाथं वागीशजस्वदने लक्ष्मीर्जस्व च वक्षसि यस्यास्ते हृदय संवित् त्वं नृसिंहमहं भजे हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। निष्किंचनस्य भगवद् भजनोन्मुखस्य परं परं जिगमीश भवसागरस्य सन्दर्शनं विषयानं अतो स्त्रीणामपि विषयानं। निष्किंचनस्य भगवद् भजनोन्मुखस्य परं परं जिगमीश भवसागरस्य सन्दर्शनं विषयनमूपि यशिदानंच हा हंत विषभक्षणत्वपि असाधु। गौड़ीय गोष्ठीपति श्रीशील भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर जगद्गुरु प्रभुपाद टोल्ड दैट वी मस्ट गेट रीड ऑफ एनी अट्रैक्शन और रिपल्सन। We must get out of any attraction or repulsion, any matters here in this material world. We must go out of this influence of Maya. Any kind of attraction and repulsion we should not have inside our heart, because it is against Hari Bhajan. First of all, we must get rid of any influence of any attraction or repulsion of these worldly objects. This is our first objective. Hari bhajan is turiyo, harir hi nirguno sakshat purusho prakete pare hai. Harir hi nirguno sakshat purusho prakete pare hai. Sa sarvadrig upradashta tang bhajano nirguno bhavet. In front of Parikshit Maharaj, Sri Sukhdev Goswami asking, Parikshit Maharaj putting one question in front of Sukhdev Goswami, yeah, Gurudev, actually, usually it is seen, those who are worshipping Durga, Kali, Mahadev, they are getting so much riches, property, this, that, so much mundane facilities they are getting, whereas those who are worshipping Krishna, Paratpara Akhileshwar, Turiya Tattva, usually they are niskinchan. Why so? Then Sukhdev Goswami going to answer he, that Rajan Harir hi nirguno sakshat purusho prakriti parehe. Hari is not a matter of this material world. Hari is beyond this material conception, beyond this material limit. So Hari hi nirguno sakshat purusho prakriti parehe. Sa sarvadrig upradashta tang bhajano nirguno bhave. Paratpara Akhileshwar, Supreme Lord Bhagavan Sri Krishna, sitting inside the heart of everybody as Paramatma, Aniruddha Vishnu, Kherodha Gosai Aniruddha Vishnu. He is watching everything. Even if I am going to do something which is unusual, very offensive, inside room, nobody can see me, but still, Paramatma is there, he can arrest me immediately, what you are doing. So, actually, Supreme Lord saying inside the heart of everybody, but inside the heart of Guru Vaishnav, Krishna feeling relaxed, taking rest. And inside the heart of all bonded soul also Krishna there, Supreme Lord, but in passive form, they cannot realize. And Bhagavan Sri Krishna also not feeling comfortable there, because all the time some or different kind of demands, attraction, repulsion, or you know, contamination there, annavilas. It is very easy. I know it is very easy to speak this word. Annavilasita sunyam jnana karmadi anabritam anukulena krishnanusiram sabhukti. It is very easy to speak, to recite. It is very easy to recite, but if you go deep into this philosophy, in this, you know, feeling, you can go mad. It is rare. Such a sadhu is almost rare in this world. Why we cannot digest all the Siddhanta Vichara of Prabhupada? Because whatever is spoken in front of us, we always want to search our experience bank. If we don't find any experience which is not going to support our material mind, then we can say it's not good, it is bad. Which is good, which is bad, we are going to pass judgment. So we are bonded soul, whereas I yesterday already told, Prabhupada speaking, bonded soul anyhow, by his personal effort, can never attain absolute good. It is not possible. One has to sell his head. One has to sell his head unto the lotus pure Guru Vaishnava to attain 100% success this life. If you have some other objectives, I am not going to play my head. But one thing is right, that you declare yourself that you are peasant. You declare yourself as peasant, that I am peasant. If you are not going to declare yourself as peasant, why you have taken shelter unto the lotus feet of Gurudev? Then again, yesterday's discussion, kapat. Those who are interested to deliver themselves from this bonded condition, maya, they should sell their head unto the lotus feet of pure Guru Vaishnava. I mean, 100% submission should be there. And after that, when Guru Vaishnava going to give medicine, when Guru Vaishnava, you declare yourself as patient, but when Guru Vaishnava going to give you medicine, you are going to pass your remark, this is bitter, this is sweet, this is sour, it's not good, the medicine is very bad. Actually, you have no right to pass any remark about the medicine given by Guru Vaishnava. That is the first question. You have no right to pass any remark about the medicine given by Guru Vaishnava. They are giving medicine according to a disease. If you have 100% faith in Guru Vaishnava, why you are going to pass any remark about medicine given to you? You have no right. Yesterday I was discussing this point, that until and unless we are feeling tremendous attraction, not material love. Material love is material. Material love is material. Actually, it has no connection with, because matter and antimatter cannot tally. First disease we have, the first disease is that always we want to reconcile Chetan and Jada. Jada means matter. Samannoy. We all do it. Always. This is our chronic disease. This is our chronic disease. Always we want to reconcile anything spiritual and material. This is our chronic disease. So, Samannoy Bhat. It is called Chit Jada Samannoy. Prabhupada used to say Chit Jada Samannoy. First of all, you will have to throw it out. Balavan adaro jasona sad guru padambuje srutoi ropitasso sasastroir kishne bhakti najayate. First of all, you will have to put question in front of yourself, that really you want to get Krishna bhakti? Really you want to get Krishna bhakti, which is a rare thing, rare, which is most rare thing. Krishna bhakti, Krishna like to pay you whenever you like to show I have done some seva for Krishna. Krishna like to pay you something. Ye yathamang prapadante tang stathi bhajamyam. It is the usual rule. Anything you are doing, then Krishna can pay you back. But Krishna don't like to give bhakti, which is a rare treasure. Rare. Muktim dadati sma na bhakti yogam. Somehow Krishna can give mukti, but bhakti Krishna don't like to give because it's rare. Because if Krishna going to give bhakti to you, Krishna bhakti if you are going to get, then Krishna going to be controlled by you. That is the main problem. If you have having Krishna bhakti, pure Krishna bhakti, then Krishna going to be controlled by you. This is the, you know, though we know Krishna is Sarat. Yanma adasyato yanmaya dhitarashartha savigya Sarat. Savigya Sarat. You need not inform Krishna that this is happening there, in that locality. Krishna knowing everything. Because Krishna is omnipresent. Krishna is omnipresent every time, anywhere, infinity world, any corner, anywhere. Even Krishna going to take information of one dust particle there in Saturn. Everything Krishna knowing. Because everywhere Krishna. Whenever you are going some hatred, when you are giving, feeling some attraction and repulsion, that is very dangerous. In that case, you cannot concentrate in Hari Bhajan. But of course, one thing, that dhayato vishana pungsam sangastesu upajayate sangyat sangyat kam kamat krodho vijayate krodhat bhavati sanmoha sanmohat siti bibham siti bibhrangshat buddhinaso buddhinasat pranasami. This is I know. I already discussed many times. Dhyato vishwana pungsham sangasteshu upajayati. Your mind always, you know, going to think of, so many things are there inside your mind. So many things, countless things are there inside your mind. You cannot clear your mind. That is the main problem. This is the first advice of Prabhupada, that you will have to clean your mind first. That cleaning procedure should be done through aprakita harikatha kirtan from right source. This is the first advice of Prabhupada. Because if you are not going out of this influence of maya, how you can start Hari Bhajan? Because Hari Bhajan, within anartha, you are going to preserve. You are going to preserve all your anartha inside your heart. At the same time, you can do Hari Bhajan. Impossible, absurd. But anyway, you are practicing. So someday you can come out successful. So many suspension. You know, like in water, so many you can look with electronic microscope because there is so many suspension in water. In your mind, so many countless things are there. First of all, you have to clean. After proper cleaning, then you can start Hari Bhajan. With anartha Krishna Bhajan, not possible. When you are growing some hostility with somebody, when you are going to grow tremendous love affair with somebody, you can see whole day and night you are doing something, but always your mind is there. Follow. This example Mahaprabhu giving, paravyasani nari vyagrahapi griha karmasu tadaiva sadayati navasamu rakshayanam. Mahaprabhu giving this example, paravyasani nari, one chaste lady is very good. We want to be chaste lady. Now in Bhagavad you see, Your mind, when you are going to get bhakti, pure bhakti, full kripa of Guru Vaishnava and pure bhakti, then your mind is chaste mind. Actually, chaste mind. Matim satim jachati vasudeve, it is written in Bhagavatam. Matim satim jachati vasudeve, satimati means, if Satimati, question of Satimati coming, Mati Shabda, Mati is Stri Linga, actually, feminine gender. So Mati Shabda, so Matim Satim Jachati Vasudeve. Satimati, when your mind is, you know, chaste mind, Mati, that is good. But when your mind is not pure, that is asati mati. Asati mati means not chaste, is not chastised. So, this way actually, when you are feeling tremendous attraction, material repulsion, like I can give example, like Kamsa all the time concentrating on Krishna. Very, very good. It is very good. Somehow we can actually it is not favorable for us, but still Naraji Maharaj speaking, Tasmad Rajan Kenupupayena Manaha Krishna Niveshayat. Tasmad Rajan Kenupupayena Manaha Krishna Niveshayat. Somehow, anyhow, you must get concentration in Krishna's lotus feet. I am not speaking that you can do bhajan like Kamsa. I am not speaking. But Kamsa all the time concerning, going to kill me. All the time thinking about, you know, Krishna. Krishna can kill me. So that's why tanmayata, absorbing thinking. Coming in, sir? So anyhow, it is Krishna. It is Krishna, be careful, it is not material matters. So, you know, Naraji Maharaj speaking, okay, Kamsa has developed strong hostility with Krishna. Still, one positive point is that at least he is thinking about Krishna. But we cannot follow this procedure, be careful. Someday I can discuss in details, full details about anukulena bhakti anusilanam, what is anukul, what is pratikul, or in details I already discussed, I think maybe 2 years before in Mayapur, but still, because if we forget, we have so many material things in our mind, we cannot remember. Because when your heart and mind totally coincide, your heart is running somewhere, your mind is running somewhere, when you can coincide all your mind and heart, then is good, then is very good. That so if you are going to develop some attraction from material objects, then it is very dangerous, then you cannot do Hari Bhajan. So it is the advice of Prabhupada. The first of all, but we are not ready to take medicine. That is the main problem. We become very angry with Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, pure Guru Vaishnav, Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj speaking, we are really unlucky. Those pure Guru Vaishnav always try to seek our benefit, real benefit, actual benefit, ideal benefit. And speaking tremendous Harikatha, we think they are our enemy. Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj speaking, really we are unlucky. Those pure Guru Vaishnava, they have no self-interest. Maharaj, if you have any common sense, you go on thinking, if that Maharaj can speak very sweet way, that Maharaj can enjoy so many popularity. That Maharaj can get so many pranami from you, from everybody. Just I will have to cheat you. Then you can be very happy. I can give you some false pratishtha. Ah, Maharaj is very nice, Maharaj. But you are not going to think how much sacrifice those Guru Vaishnava they are doing for you all. They are not thinking about their personal pratishtha, money, position, honor, nothing. We know. If we speak that way, people going to attract me. People going to attract me, I know it very well. Mother can never allow his child, baby, to take poison. Forcefully mother going to take away the poison, you know, from the hand of the baby. This is the duty of Gauriyama, this is the duty of Vishva Vaishnava Rasava, each and every member of Vishva Vaishnava Rasava. They have their this duty. They like to save us all from danger, imminent danger. Also, many times I discussed before, Gurur na sasyat, sajjano na sasyat, pita na sasyat, sajjanani na sasyat, daivam na tatsyat. You can remember, patim na sasyat, namo chet jasam upetamithyam. What kind of guru you have accepted in your life, foolish, who is going to make you more blind? What kind of guru you have accepted in your life? He is going to make you more blind so that you cannot see anything. You are so foolish, so biased, you cannot understand even common sense you don't have. That what kind of, love the Guru Vaishnava going to show for you. Naturally, they are going to see the whole world in relation of Krishna. That's why they love everybody, each and every creature of this world. They always can think, always they can feel that Krishna is there. That's why Rai Ramananda Sangbad, when Rai Ramahasai is speaking, Prabhu, don't try to cheat me. What I see? What you see? I see you are Brajendanandan with Radharani embracing, and now I see again the same, you are actually a great devotee, you are looking everywhere Radha Krishna, because Ishtadev, you are Ishtadev. Don't try to, cheat me, Prabhu. Please, speak me, what are you? Prabhu first wanted to cheat. This is cheating, Prabhu. It is usually there. Krishna always cheating. Krishna like to cheat. Gauranga Mahaprabhu, Guru Vaishnava also like to cheat you. But when they can see that tremendous love you have for Guru Vaishnava, no way they can first speak all rubbish. They can insult you. Hey, go away from me. Foolish. Don't come to me. They can speak this way. If you are going to digest this and say Maharaj is acting actually, then if you are going to show your, tremendous attraction, then they cannot avoid you. First of all, they can act. Like one Sundaranda Thakur, his part is Gaur Parshad from that place. One Gosai, a so-called Gosai. I am not going to give this title to him. He is enjoying this title. He came to Gaur Kishadar Bhai Maharaj and paying dandavat. Maharaj, I like to learn Rupanuga Bhajan from you, Raganuga Bhajan from you. Actually, I have no time today. Then after next day coming, Srila Babaji Maharaj speaking same thing. Actually, I have no time today, so I am so much busy. Again coming. For 7 days, consecutively 7 days, Babaji Maharaj cheating him. After that he is going to lose his patience, speaking, useless. I am coming continuously and no time. Okay. He gone away. Srila Babaji Maharaj laughing and speaking in himself. Huh. They cannot bear even if one penny is going to lose, they cannot bear that kind of, they cannot bear even if one penny is going to be lost. They are going to lose one penny, they cannot bear. They are coming to learn Rupanuga Bhajan. Billions of dollars in my bank I can keep. And, I can sit in AC room and I can do Rupanuga Bhajan. So easy, eh? So easy, so cheap. At present, his bhajan is very cheap, standard low. Prabhupada never wanted to bring the standard down. Prabhupada never allowed. So they cannot bear even, they have so many attractions in their material life. And they are coming to learn Raganuga Bhajan from me. Babaji Maharaj speaking and laughing. Someday, Babaji Maharaj, what happens? Very nice dhoti. Very nice dhoti. We like a you know, son-in-law. Very nice dhoti. Like, you know, newly married man. New jamai. Follow. Is giving a very nice cloth and everything. And French cut beard making. And coming in Sananda Sukhata Kunja. In front of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Bhaktivinoda Thakur laughing. What happens? Babaji Maharaj, what happens to you? Babaji Maharaj laughing. Babaji Maharaj laughing and speaking. Now nobody can attack me. Now nobody can attack me. If I am going to talk with woman, you know, I can do anything if I like. Now nobody going to attack me. Now I am French card, dari, you know, beard, and you know, I am, you know, like son-in-law. What Babaji Maharaj wanted to speak? That in the name of bhajan and harikatha, hari bhajan, if we are going to contaminate this namahatta, then any paramahansa cannot bear. Any sadhu, he cannot bear. He like to give his life. If a freedom fighter going to lie, give his life for motherland, why? We cannot give life for Bhaktivinod Saraswati Dwara. We cannot give our life. Why not? Then what kind of dedication I have, what kind of sacrifice I have, I cannot give. Be sure, don't try to express any doubt about this point. That those pure Guru Vaishnav, they are really Paramahansa. They are really Paramahansa. But when they have their responsibility, when they have their responsibility to speak Harikatha, to show acharan in front of you, they are so strict that you cannot bear him. You can pass him, he is not at all Paramahansa. Why is he speaking that way? Maharaj, Prabhupada speaking, that it is my responsibility to check all followers. I am speaking heavily. Why you are going to take trouble? Why you are running into fire? You going to criticize? Why you not try to check yourself? You have thousands of faults, countless faults. It is my responsibility. I am acting as Acharya. I need to chastise my followers. So I am doing that kind of job. You are going to take, You are going to take this kind of responsibility. Why? I have never given you this kind of responsibility. Pure Guru Vaishnav can sit any solitary place. They can do bhajan whole life. They are not even like to look who is there outside gate. Less interested. Absorbingly they are going to do bhajan. One Vaishnav, one Vaishnav. They can stay inside solitary cabin. Castle for months. But still, when they have their responsibility to speak Harikatha, to check the situation, to control the situation, in that case, it is their responsibility to speak Harikatha. Then you cannot pass remark that they are going to criticize. Even after speaking so heavy thing, they are not going to get any punishment. Because their heart is equipoised. There is no disturbance inside their heart. They have no, party color inside their heart. Simply they love everybody. Each and everybody. But they are speaking to save me. They are speaking to save us from imminent danger. Even when in Shastra it is written, that Guru is not Guru. That Guru is not Guru. That near and dear one, actually your friend, is not your friend. That father is not at all your father. That mother is not at all your father. That demigod is not at all demigod whom you are, unnecessarily you are going to love him. And that husband is not husband, actually, who is not going to save you from imminent danger. Who is going to save us, Guru Vaishnava. That is why they are speaking this way. We always going to pass this kind of remark about Prabhupada. Prabhupada is a big critic. Prabhupada is always going to speak heavily. There's no mercy there. What do you mean by mercy? What do you think about mercy? So the point you should remember always, that until and unless you can develop tremendous, genuine love for Guru Vaishnava. Until and unless you are going to develop tremendous, strong love for Guru Vaishnava, there is no possibility that you can get Krishna. In Vrindavan, there is one nice, you know, Brajavasi log, they are, you know, speaking in a very joking mood. Arey Maharaj, agar gardan deke bhi Bhagwan milta hai, to bhi socho ki sasta hai. If I am going to give my head, cut my head and give to Krishna, and Krishna going to sell himself in front of me, then still it is very cheap. If I am going to give my head unto the lotus feet of Krishna, and Krishna going to assure me, you can get me, then it is very cheap. To bhi sasta hai mara. So you see, you can remember, when Mukunda is, you know, going here and there, Mukunda love Prabhu very much, the Prabhu going to give him punishment. Prabhu going to give love, distribute, and a prema to everybody. Devotee is asking, oh, you are not giving to Mukunda. No, I cannot give to Mukunda. Mukunda is sahajiya. He is going here and there. So you are angry with Prabhupada. Why you are not angry with Mahaprabhu? Mahaprabhu speaking. Even Mukunda is tremendous love for Gaurhari. But still Mahaprabhu is saying, no, he is going here and there. Whenever he is going this group, he is, you know, like, you know, they are going to change color, adjusted there, and again coming here. So I cannot. He is Khorjatiya. Khorjatiya. Khorjatiya, no? This is Bengali meaning. Even those who are learning Bengali, they cannot understand. It's very typical. Khorjatiya means sometimes with straw, with you know, straw in teeth, going to pay dandavat to you, please save me. And sometime going to take stick and going to beat me. Both. You know, Mahaprabhu says, no, I cannot give. Then after that, when devotee is requesting, Prabhu, you, please, Mukunda is, you know, all the time doing kirtan, staying with you. Okay, after one crores of years, I can give. Then Mukunda, going to get this information, started dancing full heavy, and started dancing. Prabhu speaking, hey, why is dancing? Prabhu, you confirm that after 1 crore of years, you are going to bless, you are going to, you know, give Krishna. Oh, really? So much strong belief. Come. Your 1 crore years gone. Because time, space and matter all controlled by Krishna. You can remember Rasa Leela. Brahma Ratri. How long this Rasa Leela was there? Brahma Ratri. You cannot imagine, you cannot calculate. But still those gopikas thinking, within this twinkling of eyes, that Rasa Leela gone. Oh, just started and now finished. So time, space and matter, everything controlled by Krishna. So you see, so long as we are not going to develop that kind of tremendous love for Guru Vaishnava, there is no possibility that we can get Krishna Bhakti. Krishna Bhakti is not so cheap. I can do business in Dham, I can cheat people, I can do anything, I can get Bhakti. Because I have Tilak Mala, everything? No, useless. It is useless. So first of all, I told you that attraction and repulsion, this kind of thing should not be there. Material attraction and repulsion should not be there inside our heart. This is the first point Prabhupada wanted to establish, this point. After that, I can start Hari Bhajan under the guidance of pure Guru Vaishnava. If at all If at all I am not going to get pure Guru Vaishnava in front of me, then I will have to wait. This is the advice of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Prabhupada repeatedly told, so-called Diksha, so-called Diksha and original Diksha, not same. How much, how far I am deviated from the track of Prabhupada. Prabhupada never confess. People never confess those sahajya they are initiated. Are if you are at all initiated, then you show that you have your Dibya Gyan. Where is your Dibya Gyan transcendental knowledge? Diksha is there, but you are not growing any, getting any Dibya Gyan. How is that possible? It is not possible at all. So Krishna always going to cheat us. Dadati muktim smana bhakti yogam. And Krishna not going to give us bhakti. But when Krishna discovered that, okay, he is not going to take anything from me. He is not a businessman. We should not believe any businessman. Maybe he is acharya, he is sannyasi, brahmachari, any position. You should not believe a businessman. Business mentality is there, you should not believe him at all. Prahlad Maharaj speaking, then to in front of Nishingadev, Prabhu, Shaboi Banika, he is businessman, not Sevak. He is not a servant, Sevak. He is a businessman. A businessman can serve Gurudev. You cannot discover because you have no Tattva Gyan. Even I am in Vyasasana, I can promise and say that Gauriya Siddhanta, I mean Saraswat Gauriya Siddhanta is so fine, so high that I feel shy to speak in front of you. I feel shy, nobody can understand. If you say that nobody can understand what you are speaking, try to remember that you want to do Krishna Bhajan. The Krishna Bhajan is not so cheap. Any Siddhanta spoken by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, we can get from Prabhupada. Any Siddhanta vichar of Radharani, we can get from Prabhupada. But we are not ready to obey Prabhupada 100%. Okay, I can obey, but 50%. 50% division is there. We are not ready. Then how we can get? So this way, I told yesterday, the main thing is that Guru Vaishnava can attract you like magnet. Don't try to forget this point. Guru Vaishnava can attract you like a magnet through their Harikatha Bani. Prabhupada speaking, this is the main thing. This is the main thing, vital thing. Prabhupada, you know, through Bani, tremendous Bani, tremendous Harikatha. Yeah, if you are not going to feel tremendous attraction through Bani, Vaibhava of Gurudev, then be sure he is not Sadguru. It's the first thing. Guru Vaishnava can attract you through their tremendous Harikatha. You cannot get scope to move your head here and there. Even you cannot get scope to move your head towards Maya. Tremendous Harikatha. You are bound to pay attention to Gurudev. He is Sadguru 100% who is going to catch your full attention. Full attention, come. He cannot get any scope to look at Maya. And through Bani Vaibhav, through Bani Sharup, Sadguru can catch you. That's why repeatedly Prabhupada told, don't try to run here and there. You will have to pay attention. You have to engage your ear in front of a real source. I am not a university lecturer. You cannot expect a nice piece of lecture from me. because I am not a university lecturer. You cannot expect nice language from me because I am not linguist. What you can expect from me? That direct feeling of seva. That direct feeling of seva that I have received from my Paramahansa Guru Pad Padma, seva and siddhanta all same. Follow what I say. You can expect what? That direct feeling that I have, that direct feeling of seva, I have received from my Guru Pad Padma. He wanted to inculcate inside me, my heart. That I can share with you, of course, if you are really interested. Of course, if you are really interested, then I can share with you, otherwise I can keep silence. I can speak Harikatha if there is no place, I can speak Harikatha there. Under a banyan tree, what wrong in it? Whereas topmost Jagat Guru, Bhagavan Shankar, Vaishnavanam Jatha Sambhu, speaking Harikatha in front of all sages, Muni Rishis, sitting under a banyan tree, you can go through Bhagavatam, there you can find. Dakha Yajna there, after that, demigods are along with Brahma, approaching him and find he is sitting under a banyan tree and speak Harikatha. But at present, people cannot see there is so much disturbance and that's why problem. Otherwise, what problem? Harikatha. For Harikatha, we need Sattik Parivesh, Sattik environment, not any external facility. You know, for preaching purpose, we need, okay. So it's called Yukta Vairagya. For actual preaching of Chaitanya Vani, we will have to accept some external facility. That's why Prabhupada told, we are going to speak Harikatha here and there, in Calcutta, in different place, where not. Every people coming. Not that Matajis cannot come, Pitaji can come, not that, everybody can come. So they can come. But I was bound to discuss this heavy point that we have some idea, material idea. Bonded soul always busy with material darshan. Just half an hour before I was discussing, na? Rai Ramanando speaking, Prabhu, who are you? Please speak me. After that, Mahaprabhu was bound to confess. But before, Mahaprabhu wanted to cheat him. Mahaprabhu speaking, it is a symptom of Mahabhagavat. Jaha jaha netra pare taha Krishna spure. It is the usual, you know, it is quite natural that you are Mahabhagavat, so anywhere you look, you can find your Ishtadev. Prabhu, don't try to cheat me, please speak me. Jaha jaha netra pare taha Krishna spure. Kabe habe bolo sedina amar. Bhaktivinoda Thakur write, na? Tomorrow we'll have to speak something about, but the topics tomorrow is little bit different. And on Rathe Yatra Day, little bit different. But we can get in touch. Kabe habe bolo sedino amar. Dhano jano yar kobita sundari. Bolibo na chahi deho sukho kori, janme janme deho ohe gauro hori, ahe tu ki bhakti charone tomar, kabe habe bolo sedino yam. We will have to sing from heart. We will have to cry with one kartal. We will have to see. We will have to sit and cry in front of Guru Varga. Kabe habe bolo sedina amar. Too much material. All environment is so, you know, contaminated that it is really very difficult for somebody to consider in bhajan. You are getting some exclusive advantage. In the name of Prabhupada I am speaking, that Nityananda Prabhu and Bhaktivinoda Thakur Guru Varga going to give us some exclusive advantage. If you are going to throw this advantage, then we cannot expect an eternal mangal to come in your life in billions of birth. Next. First of all, Baba speaking, those who are busy with shape and design, those who are always busy with shape and design, no? You know? Whenever we look here and there, we can find blood and flesh. This blood and flesh conception, this blood and flesh darshan, rakta mangsha, mangshadrik and vedadrik. Prabhupada always used to speak mangshadrik and vedadrik. Avadarshan is whenever you find, look, we can find blood and flesh. Jaha jaha netro pare, taha rakta mangsha spure. Jaha jaha netro pare, taha Krishna spure. Mahabhagavat. But jaha jaha, whenever I look, I can find blood and flesh. When we can realize that our body is just a sack of blood and flesh, when I can start hating my body, ha! Useless body. Always I need to reserve some time for sleeping, eating. I am wasting so much time. Useless body. Ha! Useless body. When I can start hating my body, if I can start, the day I can start hating my body is very green signal. Too much attraction for my own body and body-related things. And I want to do Krishna bhajan. In Bengali, one very nice, you know, proverb going on there. Sham rakhi na kul rakhi. You know, sham rakhi na kul rakhi. If I want to satisfy all my relatives, then I cannot get Krishna. If I going to satisfy Krishna, I cannot satisfy my all relatives and friends. Then a decision, what decision to take? It's up to you. But anyway, Bhaktivinoda Thakur is writing in Sajjan Tasani that any amount of your preaching, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, any amount of your preaching without acharan cannot yield any result, cannot give any result. Any amount of a harikatha, you can run America, Russia, France, Italy, but any amount of your harikatha kirtan cannot give exact result. Because it cannot change. It cannot change. Harikatha mean acharya. Why acharya is so important? Because acharya can change the heart of bonded soul. He can influence him. That is why acharya, acharya mam bijaniyat, Krishna speaking. And everybody is speaking, I am acharya. Everybody cannot act as acharya. Bonded soul cannot act as acharya. Symptoms are there. We are so idiot, day by day we are going to throw all books, you know, all Goswami books we want to avoid. Some glamour, position, respect we are going to get, is right, is Hari Bhajan. But Prabhupada speaking, if you have taken resolution to do Hari Bhajan, it is your first duty to avoid asasanga. You will have to eradicate the root cause of asasanga. If asasanga is there, it is just like worm inside your belly. You are taking so nice, you know, nice, you know, vitamin, minerals, but all taken by those worms. You are not, your nourishment, body nourishment is stopped. Prabhupada speaking, I am not speaking. So, you try to calculate, you to try to draw one final account, the how far, how much we are deviated from the track of Prabhupada. Prabhupada always want to, you know, advise us, stop asasanga. Knowingly, unknowingly, anyhow, bonded soul cannot avoid asasanga, mental asasanga, physical asasanga, any kind of by body, speech or mind, all the time you are going to do asasanga some or other way. Chirandi sannyasa is not a matter of joke. That's why Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, if the number of sannyasis, brahmachari, renounce order increasing, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, it must be a plotting of maya. Renounce order. I like to enter into it. It's very easy. You can beg me, I can lead my life very nicely. Maharaj, you don't know the far-reaching consequence of your life. If I am going to beg from you, if I am not going to do bhajan, not going to pay, what a painful result I will have to suffer next life, even this life also. So the first advice Prabhupada giving, are you ready to accept the first advice of Prabhupada? Knowingly, unknowingly, why I am going to speak so many secret things of bhajan? So that at least I can save somebody. I know everybody going to jump into fire. As somebody can say, Maharaj, I am okay. But his situation is just like that. He is going to fire. His position is very, it's one kind of laughing stroke. He is speaking, Maharaj, my position is very okay. I am Acharya, I am this. Maharaj, your position is like that. You are already in frying pan. This is the difference. You are already in frying pan, and from frying pan, you are going to jump into glowing fire. What is the difference? You are going to jump from frying, you are already in frying pan. Your position is there, you are already in inside a frying pan. And from there, you are now at present, you are going to jump into glowing fire. So anyway, to avoid asasanga is not a matter of joke. Only one magic is there. Only one magic I can teach you. I cannot teach you. I am going to repeat what Prabhupada told. Only one procedure is there. What is that procedure? That procedure is when you are absorbingly busy in Guru Seva. The only procedure. When you are absorbingly busy in Guru Seva, then it is the duty of Gurudev to take you on lap and cross this material ocean. It is the responsibility of Sadguru Vaishnava. It is not your responsibility. Only your responsibility is there to show 100% submission. The next responsibility, is that Guru Vaishnava going to save you from Maya. That you can automatically. There is the only procedure there. So, we are always busy with shape and design. This kind of darshan, whenever we look, we are always watching this kind of, dirty darshan of flesh and blood, material darshan. Even Prabhupada speaking, until and unless we are going to get rid of history and allegory, until and unless we are going to get rid of history and allegory, we cannot start Hari Bhajan. Nobody can imagine, even in dream. So much thousands of philosophers may be there. They can memorize whole books of philosophies. But still they cannot enter into this feeling, what Prabhupada wants to speak in front of us. That doesn't mean we can all throw Prabhupada. We cannot enter into so what use. No. Guru Bhargo, Siddhar Goswami, Keshav Goswami speaking, that Prabhupada Siddhanta is like, Prabhupada Vichar is just like coconut. Coconut, you know? Outside coconut is very hard. If you give this coconut to any bird, you cannot take as a wooden structure outside. Those who are foolish, they can throw. But those who have idea, they can break this coconut with some, and after that they can get sweet water inside, after so nice mala inside, eh? Narkel, nariyal, coconut, very nice. So our Guru Varga used to speak, my son, forcefully you cannot enter into the area of Prabhupada. Area of Prabhupada means any Siddhanta Vichar, anything Prabhupada you have, you cannot get access, you cannot enter. Because you have material idea, you have doubts. So if you forcefully like to enter into this philosophy, then trespassers will be prosecuted. Trespassers will be prosecuted, like you like to translate the letters of Prabhupada, you are so idiot, you like to change the meaning. You don't understand, you think you are knowing English very well. Arey Maharaj, who is interested about English? I like to throw English, Bengali, Hindi, Sanskrit, I like to throw. I like to get direct feeling. You are going to pass remark that you can clean the language of harmonist. So idiot you are. Are a harmonist, you know, transcendental. Your father cannot see. Huh? You are a great philosopher, a great language, you know. Nobody there to object. Nobody there. Everybody running. With, you know, for Maya and this, that, they are running. Nobody there to protest. Why you are speaking like this? Nobody there. So, first of all, we learn from our Guru Varga, it is really so. Material people, with their material efforts, they cannot get entry into the darshan, vichar, siddhanta of Srila Prabhupada. But, you can get entry. You can get entry. One, you know, devotee started staying with me right from the temple. He is not educated. He cannot even sign. But gradually he go on hearing from me, Harikatha from me. Then after that he can memorize. See, after that he is doing opera, then fall down. This is different case. But previously, even a great pandit, he is going to pass a reading the Siddhanta Prabhupada speaking wrong. And he is not, you know, he is not educated, speaking, no, this Siddhanta is this. When fighting going on, he came to me and I say, you are speaking right. So you are educated, not educated, that's not a big matter. Automatically you can grow that kind of sensitivity. You can understand what Prabhupada means to say. Material people, those who are having some duplicity, in infinity period, they cannot do Hari Bhajan. They can never do Hari Bhajan. How we can expect that can get entry into the darshan, vichar, siddhanta of Prabhupada? We cannot expect. So we can get entry by the mercy of Prabhupada very easily. So, yesterday I was speaking that those who are going to feel attraction, material attraction and repulsion, I mean those who are busy with shape and design darshan. Raktamangsa, there is a nice, beautiful lady, there is a handsome man, very nice. This is called actually, there is old man. You know, this darshan is called blood and flesh darshan. Bloody, we are bloody. So, this kind of darshan cannot allow me to enter into the area of Hari Bhajan. Not at all. You can remember what Mahaprabhu told. Yesterday also I was discussing, but so big area. Any amount of discussion, by the mercy of Nityananda, I am going to discuss, but still I am not getting any satisfaction. You know, Mahaprabhu, you can remember what Mahaprabhu told. Akarad opi bhedabhyam srinam vishayanam opi. Mahaprabhu told, that Vishayi material people and women, if they shape and design, only shape and design, is very fearful, Mahaprabhu told. Mahaprabhu told us, very fearful. Those who are taggy, those who are entering into renounce order, they should be very busy about, very careful about material man, Vishayi, and woman, all the time. They should have right darshan. Why Mahaprabhu speaking? Akarad opi vedabhyam srinam vishayina opi. Mahaprabhu and our tikaka, those who are commentary writing, Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur, they speaking, even there is no, you know, actually there is no snack, but if one false snack is there, still you can become very, one day it happens so. I was in Bhajan Kuti, there in Gokul, forest almost. In the morning time when I get out, I find one snack not moving at all. And why not moving? I'm thinking, I cannot cut me because I know Prabhu is there. But after I'm waiting for sunrise, I find, no, it is not snack. It is the skin. It is simply the skin of the snack. Follow? But still, this skin, external design of the snack is also fearful. External design of snack is also very dangerous. Similarly, external design, shape and design, if you at all have this kind of darshan, shape and design, then if you are going to watch a woman, is dangerous. That's why Mahaprabhu told, Daru Prakriti Hare Munarapimon. Even the wooden statue, wooden, you know, model of woman with clothes and ornaments is very dangerous. And Rupa Goswami Pad proclaiming in front of Prabhu, Prabhu, better you can keep me inside a cage. Prabhu, better you can put me inside a cage and set fire everywhere. Everywhere fire, I am inside a cage, I cannot fly. That's still okay. But still, don't allow me to stay with material person, Vishayi. We are not going to get that place of Harikatha because that man is businessman. I am not going to invite snack into Bhajan Kutir. Anyway, I can throw this opportunity. Like dustbin, like, you know, garbage I can throw. I don't need this kind of paper. So, any shape and design also dangerous. Of shape and design, if you have any material darshan, Rupa Goswami Pad speaking, Baram hutavaha panjarantar vyavasthiti. Baram hutavaha jala panjarantar vyavasthiti. Hutavaha jala panjarantar vyavasthiti. Better if you, Prabhu, you can keep me inside a cage and set fire everywhere. But still, don't allow to get the association of material person. Maybe he is in the form of acharya, maybe in the form of sannyasi, brahmachari, grihas, any. We like to avoid material person. Material person, we like to avoid. Common people so foolish, Maharaj, I went to that rich man's house. He is a great devotee, Maharaj. And how you know? There is pictures everywhere. A Kalyanak pictures, a Nishingadev picture. I thought, you know, foolish. Why? He is not devotee. He is not devotee, he is putting picture of Radha Krishna, Kaliyadam, Rasa Leela. It is one kind of his sensual enjoyment. In the morning time, he can take tea and look at the picture of Radharani with material mood. He can look at Kaliyadam and Krishna. Krishna is his servant. Krishna dancing on, you know, Kalyanak, and we are watching. Are you have your eyes? You have your eyes to see Kaliyadam and Leela? Foolish? You like to see Kaliyadam Lava with material eyes? So garbage here in this material world, done by previous, you know, previous Acharya, they are wanted to save us. But now so much garbage recently. If somebody going to give me 500 years, still I am going to express doubt, I can clean the whole world from this kind of Mayavad Vichara, this kind of dirty conception people developing all over the world. Everybody thinking, I am doing Krishna Bhajan. Okay, you do. Why you are going to disturb me? You do your Hari Bhajan under the guise of Sabmati. Don't disturb me. How to rectify the situation? Simply they cannot understand that this is enjoying mood, this is devotional mood. This simple thing they cannot understand. So long they are doing bhajan, still today they cannot understand simple thing. Simple thing they cannot understand. How they can expect? Enjoying mood this is. Yesterday you also told, you are going to get prasadam, Vrindavan, so many rich people coming. Malai, card they are taking the darshan of Bihari ji. Garbage, they are increasing garbage in this devotional field, Namahatta. If you have tremendous love for Prabhupada, you will have to sacrifice your life. If you have tremendous love for Bhaktivinoda Thakur Prabhupada, you will have to sacrifice your life. You are woman, you are man, I am less interested about that. You have to sacrifice your life and show that you are doing cleaning job. At least we will have to try. Bhaktivinoda Dara can never be extinct. We will have to fulfill this, you know, commitment, instruction of Prabhupada. Niskinchanasya bhagavad bhajanun mukasya parang parang jigo misha ho sargas bhavasagarasya sandarshanam visvayanamupi yashitarancha ha hanto hanto visha bhakkanutto vyasadu. Mahaprabhu speaking, better if you can take poison and commit suicide, still good. But with renounce order, you are already in renounce order, you are sannyasi, brahmachari. But you are leading your life more dangerous, you know, dangerous than one material grihastha. This is not allowed. Anyhow, I cannot confess. You all can leave me alone. I know, you can leave me alone. You can go away leaving me. Still, I am not going to confess. I am not going to confess. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, any amount of harikatha, any amount of kirtan you are doing, preaching, cannot give any result until and unless you are established in acharan, going to change their heart by your acharan. If your acharan and harikatha all in line, then automatically it's an automatic factor. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, so many things in Sajjantasani. Surely we are going to take some help from Gyastha devotees. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. That doesn't mean I am going to sell my head unto the lotus feet of these Gyastha devotees. That doesn't mean. They are helping me for preaching Harikatha. That doesn't mean I am going to sell my head. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. That if we are going to sell our head, compromise with their contamination and a contaminated heart, then our preaching is all useless. Our preaching is all the flop, flop preaching, flop. You know? Flop. Your preaching come to a flop end. You are going to take advantage. Okay, you can take advantage. Help from a Gyastha Bhakta. That doesn't mean you are going to get contaminated by that, because he is influential, has some money, social position, going to influence you, you are going to lose your own position, you are deviated from the track of Prabhupada. Never Prabhupada told. Our Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada Jagadguru never wanted to enter in any kind of compromise. Prabhupada was also into the house of Grihastha Bhakta like Aprakita Prabhu. Aprakita Prabhu, you know, Goswami Maharaj. Paramananda Prabhu, their house they went, But Prabhupada never wanted to make any compromise with their material efforts. We are not going to compromise with them. Rather, we will have to influence them by our acharan to change their heart. In the name of preaching, all playing going on. At least they can practice doing Harinam. It is actually acting. They can practice doing, you know, Ekadasi, at least Maharaj. You don't know how to preach. Because you are not going to preach in front of yourself. First you will have to preach in front of yourself. First you will have to preach in front of yourself. If you are successful, then you can go outside. Otherwise your material darshan, you can go outside in the name of preaching and only make money, business. Sell prasadam, sell these photo, this you can do. Totally businessman. Totally business. Mahaprabhu speaking that akarad opi bhedavyam srinam vishayanam opi. Any kind of shape and design, materials, darshan should be thrown away first. Because you are having passive kama inside your heart. What I mean to say, please try to understand. Don't become angry with me. Of course, if you become angry, still I never mind. Why I told yesterday this so heavily? Kamukha apasanti kamani mayam jagat. Lubdha apasanti dhanamayam jagat. Dhira apasanti narayanam mayam jagat. Kamukha, those who have passive calm, dirty come, they can go outside, they can find some beautiful lady, this can. Whole world is full of women, nice lady. And lubdha pasanti dhanamayam jagat. Those were, very, very dirty, those were all a business attitude. They have always attraction for money, position. Whenever they look here and there, they can look money, dhanamayam jagat. Oh, there is so much money in America. You can go very easily and collect money. Lubdha pasanti dhanamayam jagat. Everywhere we can collect money. Arthalab eyase bhamiya phile deshe deshe. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing. It is my duty to travel all around the world, in search of money. Arthalab eyase bhamiya phile deshe deshe. Country to country I am going for preaching, for collecting money. Arthalab eyase bhamiya phile deshe deshe. And dhira, those who are sadhu, they are always looking here and there, they can find Krishna or Narayan. Whole world is full of Narayan. Where is woman? Where is woman? Prabhu is there inside their heart. First of all, that's why I told you, you will have to realize that your body is a full of, is sack, a dirty sack full of stool, urine, and flesh. The day you can realize this point, you can start Hari Bhajan. I promise you. The day you can realize from heart, you can start hating your body. Useless body. Useless body. I need to reserve some right for eating, sleeping, Popa speaking. I need to reserve, preserve some time for this and that. I cannot do Hari Bhajan properly. When we can get that kind of feeling? So, kamuka apashanti kamini mayam jagat, lubdha apashanti dhanamayam jagat, dhira apashanti narayanamayam jagat. Anywhere you look, you can find your Gurudev is coming in this form. My Gurudev going to test me, coming in this form. Whenever you are going and preaching in bonded condition, you can make some garbage all around the world. You can make garbage all around the world. And whereas Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada, Guru Varga giving their blood, giving their whole life, for cleaning this Namhatta. So merciless you are. You don't like to cooperate with Bhaktivinoda Thakur Prabhupada and Guru Bhargava for the cleaning seva of this Namhatta. You are going against Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur. You want to follow a sahaja procedure. You don't like to understand that what you are doing. What you are doing, you don't understand what kind of garbage you are making in the name of, you know, preaching, you know. Even a child in Gauriya society, even a child, they can understand this Siddhanta. Very simple Siddhanta. That Guru Vaishnav never going to take birth according to a karma fall. No janma karma bandhanam vaishnavanam cha vidyate. Even one small boy can understand. But you don't understand. You are going to translate. You are going to speak all rubbish. They are going to write that. So what a great problem. Pure devotees are never forced. Pure devotees are never forced to experience the fruits of their karma. All their pastimes, such as taking birth and enacted simply by the Lord's will. But it is often seen that the devotees appear in a low class families, Sidul caste, Sidul type, or in Muslim, or to ordinary eyes seem like fools, not educated, or we can see to be affected by disease, etc. There is a great purpose behind this. Why Krishna playing that way? Why Krishna arranged Haridas Thakur to come in a Javan family? Why Haridas Thakur arranged these devotees, that devotees to come in a low caste, low family? Why? What can be the reason? Yato dekho vaishnaver vyavaharik dukha nischay janiyo sei paramarthya sukha. Be convinced that distress, suffering, sin in a Vaishnava is actually the happiness of spiritual bliss. Persons blind and intoxicated with sense pleasure know nothing about it. Dhanamade, Vidyamade, Vaishnavna chine. Out of their vanity, billions of dollars they have. Billions of dollars we have. So who is going to care whom? Billions of dollars we have, so who is going to care whom? This is situation. So actually, so much adversity that Prabhupada is writing in letter something and they are going to person in the world. Are going to protest. Oh, they have so much money. Hey, what they can do? What they can do with money? Jarasandha was so powerful. Hiranyakashipu was so powerful. Ravan was so powerful. They are all Mayavadi. You are also Mayavadi. You are translating the writings of Prabhupada. Stop! Stop it! It is not seva for you. They are all Mayavadi. Kamsa, all Mayavadi. But be careful. They wanted to show great. They are great hooligan. They are so great hooligan that nobody can stand in front of them. You know? Duryodhan was a great hooligan. Duryodhan wanted to show big hooliganism in front of Balaji Maharaj. Then Balaji Maharaj said, they are actually blind. They cannot see. Balaji Maharaj coming here to find some solution. And Duryodhan want to insult Jadava. They are actually useless. Beggar, this. And they insult Balaji Maharaj gone. After that, Balaji Maharaj wanted to give answer. So I know they have billions of dollars. They are influential. But surely not more influential than Hiranyakasipu. Surely they are not more influential than Kamsa. Surely they are not more influential than Jarasandha, Ravan. Follow what I say. Surely they are not so much influential like Duryodhan. Even Duryodhan was kicked by Balaji Maharaj. So any kind of hooliganism in front of you, in front of us, cannot stand. Any amount of hooliganism you can show, any amount of power, I challenge you, you can put all, you can, money power, manpower, anything. If you go against any pure Guru Vaishnava, you can destroy your whole society with all your followers. You can destroy like fire. You don't know. Popa speaking, for whom I am speaking Harikatha? For whom? I am speaking Harikatha for the total satisfaction of Supreme Lord. I am not going to satisfy you. I am not going to satisfy you. In Bhagavatam we find Sukhdev Gosai, Kasmad Bhajanti Kavayo Dhanadurma Dandhan. Why those who are sadhu going to apply oil to those rich men, unto the lotus feet, rich men? Why you are going? Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, if somebody helping me in my preaching, Kriyasa Bhakta, that doesn't mean he can influence me. I can change. Prabhupada speaking, why I am speaking Harikatha? To seek the total satisfaction of Supreme Lord, to seek the total satisfaction of Supreme Lord, and to seek the satisfaction of material people, is not same. Prabhupada speaking, if the whole world going against me, still I am not going to change my decision, Siddhanta. If the whole world going against me, still I am not going to change my Siddhanta. If they want to attack me, let them come and attack me. And that absolute truth, for whom I am speaking Harikatha, that absolute truth is bound to come here in this material world to save me. That absolute truth can come here, like in front of Prahlad Maharaj. Nishimadev came. Nithananda Pashanda, Nithananda Babu Balaram, Pashanda Dalanbana. Nithananda Babu going to smash. Nithananda Babu going to smash the programs of all these material people, Mayavadis. I have no time to fight with them. I can speak Harikatha. And those who are dedicated soul, really, actually dedicated soul, unto the lotus feet of Prabhupada, they must be ready to give their life for the cause of Chaitanya Vani. Otherwise they can go back to their home, leave their sannyas base and go back to their home. It is good. Because the duty of all members of Gauriya Math. Now after so problems are created gradually one by one. That absolute truth is bound to come here in this material world. If somebody is going to attack me, then that absolute can come here in this material to protect me.
in any form can come to protect me. So I am not, you know, going to fear. So I'm very sad how they can change when Prabhupada can write this. Is it possible for Prabhupada to write that Guru Vaishnava going to take birth according to the karma phal? If I speak this way, Prabhupada can come and beat me with chappal. You are speaking this way? Totally, you want to insult Prabhupada? All along this has been the target of those demonic people. They want to change the quotation of Mahajan and put their own things. Always this has been the target of those, you know, nonsense, you know, those, you know, demons. They want to throw all the writings of Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda. You can read my writing. It's more easy. I can throw your writing into dustbin. Like just like stool and urine. I'm less interested. So this is the situation. Why Mahaprabhu? Don't try to misunderstand in Bhagavatam, it is written, Maharaj. It is written. But please don't try to misunderstand. Why it is written in Bhagavatam? Matra sastra vadvitra na vivikthasana bhavet balavana indiyagram vidyan samupikarshati. Vyasadeva Goswami writing that those who are wise men, educated, very, very wise, spiritually elevated, realize so, they should not stay with, you know, with, in a solitary place with even mother, daughter, sister, they cannot stay in solitary place. Because Balavan Indiyogramma Vidyansamupikarshati, I am giving so much example, so that you have no scope to misunderstand Prabhupada and Bhakti, you know, Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Why it is written in Bhagavatam that those who are Brihadbhati, those who are taking resolution to follow Brahmacharya Vata, Brihadbhati, even they should not touch woman by their leg. That doesn't mean it is written in Bhagavatam they can kick with leg. Not there. Don't try to misunderstand. There is a very secret point. Why? But so sensitive issue it is. Padovapi no spriset. Because it's so sensitive issue that any kind you can fall down from your bhajan. To show this kind of sensitivity, it is written. It is not advised in Bhagavatam. Because all Matajis, they respect, we respect them very much. Whenever we look any Mataji, we can think is they are their mother. We should respect them. We should respect them all the time. But why Mahaprabhu speaking this way? That even is it far better to take poison and die than doing all nonsense. Those niskinchan, those who are niskinchan, those who want to do a Bhagavad Bhajan, tagi, those who have taken resolution in their life to do Hari Bhajan. Niskinchanasya Bhagavad Bhajan unmukasya param 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 jiga misha bhavasagas. Those who want to cross over this material ocean of Maya. For them, it is advised, be very careful. Don't try to make any mistake. If you make one single mistake in your life, life is so small, so small, so small, you cannot get scope to reconcile, rectify you. So, Prabhupada is going to advise you, Prabhupada is going to advise us for actual Hari Bhajan. For actual Hari Bhajan, we must play different kind of game. What kind of game? We can cheat people for Hari Bhajan. Not that I can cheat them and collect money, not that. For actual Hari Bhajan, we can engage them in seva. And if some material people come, you can make fool of him so that he cannot get any scope to disturb me, my Hari Bhajan. I am ready to give honor to him, material pratishtha. If my giving pratishtha to you going to give me big facility in my Hari Bhajan, why not I cannot give? I surely can give. This is the secrecy of Hari Bhajan. This is the topmost secrecy of Hari Bhajan. I can discuss Radha Dasan this in our Prabhupada and Radha Dasan. That's why Mahaprabhu giving this example. Now you try to understand when I beginning what I discussed today, what I have discussed. You know, Parabhyasanani Nari Bagro Upi Griha Karmasu. Those are pros ladies, those are not chaste ladies, they are busy in their homework. But their mind is also resting with that hero. With that hero whom you love. Husband gone to office, but so no problem. So Mahaprabhu giving this example. Why? What kind of attraction a dirty lady can feel for his, hero? And he is staying in Grihastha Ashram. Mahaprabhu giving the example to clarify this point, what kind of attraction, tremendous attraction we should have for Guru Vaishnava Bhagavan. This example is topmost example given by Mahaprabhu. No more example I like to give. So, Mahaprabhu speaking, Parabhyasanani Nari Bagropi Gyo Karmasu Tadeva Sadayati Antar Navasangun Nasayanam. Internally, he is going to enjoy dirty loss with that hero. Yesterday, he wanted to kiss me that way, this, that, always rasa, material rasa, he wanted to think about. This kind of attraction, if you can just opposite, which is just dirty, and just if we make it reverse, if this kind of attraction if we put for Guru Vaishnava Bhagavan, just unique, it becomes unique. Because this material world is a perverted reflection of the transcendental world. This material world is a perverted reflection of the transcendental world. So Bhagavad Ji Mahapuran never teach us to dishonor women. No. Mahaprabhu never teach us to insult women. Mahaprabhu used to take prasadam in their Sarvam Vartajaja's house, Advaita Gosai's house, Srinivasacharya's house, why not? So much kripa they are getting. But externally, when Prabhu going to show his sannyas vrata, it should be ideal. Whenever Prabhu going to show any idealism, it is topmost idealism. When Mahaprabhu going to show grihastha idealism of grihastha life, is topmost. You can go through Chaitanya Bhagavad. How to lead grihastha life, you can learn. Krishna in Dwaraka. Also, when Mahaprabhu going to show that sannyas, idealism of a sannyas vrata, also this is topmost idealism. Aishajyasya samagyasya vijyasya jasasya sriyo. This slok you can discuss, you can understand. Anything shown by Supreme Lord is all topmost. If we say Krishna is kapat, is topmost kapat. Nobody can stand in front of Krishna. And Krishna have only right to reserve right. Krishna can reserve right to kapat. Is kapat bhav we cannot keep. It is dangerous for us. Pure Guru Vaishnava to do bhajan to satisfy Krishna, sometimes they are applying this formula. But totally Krishna have this kind of right. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu always speaking this kind of, I can discuss so many points, then you can understand. So Mahaprabhu never want to teach us to insult women. Mahaprabhu simply wanted to teach us this enjoying mood is very dangerous. Enjoying mood, yashis sangha is so dangerous, they can never do Hari Bhajan. Never. If Mahaprabhu going to insult woman, then why Mahaprabhu not going to give punishment to Rai Ramananda? Whereas Rai Ramananda going to help those young girls to take bath. Why then Mahaprabhu not going to give punishment to Rai Ramananda? Mahaprabhu sitting inside, everybody's up. Follow what I say. Jagannath Ballab Natak. Jagannath Ballab Natak written by Rai Ramananda. Very unique. And Rai Ramananda wanted to play this drama in front of Jagannath to satisfy Jagannath. Nothing else. That's why all young girls, you know, Rai Ramananda giving training to them, but Mahaprabhu is never angry with him. Why? Mahaprabhu, no. Because no, if Mahaprabhu not going to see the face of woman, it is one kind of idealism to teach us that any kind, it is so sensitive, you can fall down. This much. Not that we cannot go in preaching and in front of us, we can love those Matajis. We respect them very much. It is Gauriya Darshan. Prabhupada wanted to teach us that you cannot go in preaching with material enjoyment. So long as you have your shape and design, Darshan, you cannot go. With this dirty mood, you cannot go for preaching. So what Mahaprabhu want to speak, if you want to know, you will have to come in front of Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada. Then you can understand. Mahaprabhu want to avoid direct, you know, link with women simply because Mahaprabhu want to set the topmost idealism. In front of Prabhupada also, so many Matajis, they used to come. But Prabhupada never allow any Mataji alone. Alone Prabhupada cannot, because the topmost idealism of Acharya Sip. Many times I told before, with the manifestation of the unique Acharya Sip of Srila Prabhupada, or other so-called Acharya Sip were proved to be fake, unauthentic, false. I am not speaking 100% everybody. No. With the manifestation of the unique Acharya Sip of Srila Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Jagadguru, or other Acharya Sip were proved to be fake. You are hearing so much Harikatha, after that you go on testing, you can go. I am not teaching you to find fault with others. I am not going to teach you that you go and find fault with it. I am going to give some medicine so that you can protect yourself. If you feel that way, Maharaj is going to teach us, then I can stop my Harikatha and go and get lost. I am never going to teach you that you can find fault with others. This is not my target. My target, I am sitting in Vyasasana, I promise, is my target to protect the Siddhanta Bani, to stop those nonsense, to do all rubbish, to increase the number of the members of Vishva Vaishnava Rasabha. Duplicity I cannot allow. If you can find any problem with me, you can attack me. I can surely try to rectify myself. So with the manifestation of the unique Acharya Sip unique Acharya Siddhanta of Srila Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami, Thakur, Jagadguru, all other so-called Acharya Siddhanta were proved to be fake, unauthentic. Some of them going to show Acharya Siddhanta fall for some time. After that they are going outside, they are not saying Acharya Siddhanta. Try to understand what I mean to say. So scientific argument, infinity pure, if you wait, we cannot get the scope. If Prabhupada not going to allow us, so I am speaking, I have no credit. There Acharya Siddhanta is not all-time Acharya Siddhanta. Try to understand, it's a scientific word. There Acharya Siddhanta is not all-time Acharya Siddhanta, not eternal Acharya Siddhanta, Nitya Acharya Siddhanta. Sometimes they are showing 25% Acharya Siddhanta, 30%, 50%, but that is not eternal Acharya Siddhanta. Eternal Acharya Siddhanta shown by Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, you know, Srila Sridhar Goswami Maharaj, they wanted to show, Keshav Goswami Maharaj. They cannot even allow you one scope so that you can misunderstand. Guru Vaishnava is so merciful to you, in front of you, outside you, out of you, all the same, they are going to follow same rules and regulation. Not that in front of you, they are going to represent their great Vishnu, and when you go, they are going to follow some other rules. And this is kapat. So, pure Guru Vishnu never can show kapat bhav. So, all time Acharya Siddhanta only shown by Prabhupada. So, how far, how much we are deviated from the track of from the lotus feet of Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur, please try to understand. Please, I can catch your lotus feet all. All the time I am requesting you all, because I need all your cooperation to bring back the situation prevailing in the world at present, dirty situation. So I can request all unto your lotus feet, all devotees. All devotees, not that she is Mataji, is not Mataji, is disciple, no, nobody disciple. All you, my guru. Some or how you are going to teach me something. Really so. I learned something from you, Mama. I learned something from you. This, that, all the time I'm learning something to you. Always. So don't try to misunderstand Prabhupada. And I like to discuss so many points. What is the preaching procedure of Prabhupada and what I am doing at present, I can show you. But yesterday I told one sloka I must explain today. For Pratishtha I like to proclaim, I always like to proclaim, I am the disciple of Prabhupada because I have taken Harinam from Prabhupada. Everybody like to proclaim, they like to establish their own Pratishtha. I have taken Harinam, I have taken Diksha. But our Guru Varga, authentic Guru Varga, they already prove us. Not that, each and everybody who came in front of Prabhupada, they were successful. Not that. This is one kind of Leela. Again I am going to speak, I am not going to find any fault with anybody. I want to represent Prabhupada. That much I can do. If you think wrong, meaning misunderstand me, I have nothing to do. So, not that everybody, each and everybody who came in front of Prabhupada, took Diksha and Hariram, all there, Prabhupada Parshad, foolish. Simply for Pratishtha they are one to, totally they are deviated. They leave Prabhupada, gone to some other guru. They have taken initiation again, gone against Prabhupada, writing against Gauriya Math. Those who are going against Gauriya Math
I can touch the lotus feet of Prabhupada and speak, they are demon. They are demon number one. Automatically, I need not take any step against them. Automatically, they can destroy. They can get destroyed. Automatically. It's a one kind of curse. Automatically. I am not going to curse them. Always I want, please, if they can change their mood and try to follow the track of Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati is good for them. I am not going to pick up any enmity with them. All my friends, nobody. Like Prabhudananda Saraswati was speaking, na? Dante tinakam nidhayo padayor nipatto. Kakushat etadaham babrami he sadhava sakalameva vihayudura chaitanya chanda charane kurutanurag. Dante stinakam nidhayo padayor nipatto kakushat etadaham babrami he sadhava sakalameva vihayudura Chaitanya chanda charane kurutanuragam. Chaitanya chanda charane kurutanuragam. And Chaitanya chanda charane kurutanuragam means try to increase your attraction and love for the lotus feet of Chaitanya. But this procedure is only open in front of you through Prabhupada. You have to come through Prabhupada. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami. So each and everybody can claim for Pratishtha. My grandmother, grandfather is a disciple of a Parshad. Hare, Parshad is not so easy. Those who are going to sacrifice their life and soul for Chaitanya Vani, as shown by Prabhupada, they are the eternal Parshad of Prabhupada. They are. Those who already deviated from the track of Prabhupada, they are not Parshad. They are not persons. Someday Prabhupada can save them. Not that everybody coming in front of Prabhupada, they are all persons. No. Parshad means those who are going to give their life and soul for Chaitanya Vani. As shown by Prabhupada. Prabhupada, this way you will have to serve. You have to give your life and soul for the preaching of Chaitanya Vani. They are the eternal persons of Prabhupada. Not everybody. If everybody parsad, then it is useless Prabhupada coming here in this material world or with all of his parsad and going back, not going to deliver any new bonded soul. Is useless Siddhanta. It is useless Siddhanta. Whereas we find Paramhansa param paramatha patim patito dharane kito besha jatim Jati rajaganai pariseva padam panamami sada prabhupada padam panamami sada prabhupada padam panamami sada prabhupada padam kipaya what is written? It is the paramhansa param paramartha padim patito dharane krita vesha to deliver bonded soul, fallen soul, Prabhupada came. But you say they are initiated, that's when they are all parts of wrong Siddhanta. Only you want to enjoy some false pratishtha. Okay, we can give you false pratishtha. Why Maharaj not giving false pratishtha to us, not going to cheat us, even so heavily speaking, unbearable. Okay, you go away from me. But still I cannot cheat you. So you see, Niskin Chanasya Bhagavad Bhajan Unmukasya Parang Param Jiga Misha Bhava Sagrasya Sandarshanam Vishwayanam Atho Jashitanancho Ha Hanto Vishabhakkhanato Upiya Sadhu. Prabhupada used to strike. Prabhupada used to strike his own head. Prabhupada used to strike his own head with hand. I wanted to give so many things to them. I find nobody. They don't like to take it. Oh, they are going just opposite way. Bancha kalpata rusya ki pasindu bevacha patitanang pavane bha vaishnabhyo namo namo.